Hello and welcome to Dave Mirra's Freestyle BMX 2. I am Incetic, and with me for this game, again, is Blank Tester.
Yeah, original. Because you're not going to pick anyone else.
I could have picked Alan. I kind of wanted him to, because he apparently owned the game as well. And along with me, he started playing it again when I started playing it again. And he got frustrated and quit after 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is just a regular run through Pro Quest mode, which is career mode.
Wait, was there another Mirra in this game?
Yeah, I guess like...
his little brother?
Probably.
Wow.
So yeah, there's Dave Mirra, and then there's a bunch of people you don't care about. And the Slim Jim guy.
Oh yeah, I remember him being in this game.
Really? Like back in 2001 or...
I remember Davenport. Anyways, I remember hearing about that. I remember there was a time when everybody had all kinds of crazy hidden characters and special characters and stuff like Darth Maul and whatnot. And I remember seeing the Slim Jim guy in a game. I forgot that it was this game.
Well, Dave Mirra Freestyle BMX 2 is obviously another Tony Hawk ripoff. Came out in 2001, so I think between Pro Skater 2 and 3, pretty much doesn't add anything to the table. Is pretty much just a carbon copy. It does have a pretty good tricking system that I think they added, but it's not like Aggressive Inline, where pretty much half of the next Tony Hawk game was ripped from it.
Now, and as we saw in that weird intro, this game was also made by Z-Axis. This game was made before or after the other one?
Before.
Before Aggressive.
This one was in 2001. Aggressive Inline was a year later in 2002. And I think, after playing Dave Mirra, I think I'm going to have to retroactively go back and change my score of Aggressive Inline. Because I gave Aggressive Inline like a 6 or something out of 10. I said like... I mean, sure, it's solid, but it's not really great. Z-Axis fixed their shit from this game to Aggressive Inline. This game is so much clunkier that, like, if Aggressive Inline, the clunkiness sometimes seeped into gameplay, the clunkiness in Dave Mirra 2 is almost part of the gameplay. Like, I mean, not literally, but... you're going to see later on, it's really tough to stop, it's really tough to get turned around if you miss something, and there's a lot of awkward moments where your guy is not sure if he's going to correct himself or just sit there like a moron for 5 more seconds. And all of that really starts to add up when you're trying to do the challenges. And of course, there's a time limit in this one, but I guess in 2002, people just had the revelation that time limits... in an extreme sports game weren't that great.
Wait a minute. What did we just see? You did the rookie challenges right there?
Rookie challenge, get a certain respectable amount of points in 3 minutes.
Okay.
It was 10,000 in this. If you just hold tricks, if you just hold grabs, you should be able to get that no problem. And then amateur, once you beat rookie, comes the amateur challenges, which are... actual challenges in the level, like knock over 4 ladders or do a 360 flip. Or...
I saw it said like 2 out of 9 gaps jumped. What is that?
Well, there are gaps in these levels, much like gaps in Tony Hawk,
sure.
And such. And this level has 9 of them, which is a really small amount because it's a pretty big level, and there's a lot of possibilities for gaps, but. There's 9 of them. Once you complete all the gaps in a level, you get 1,000 more, like, respect points. Respect points is basically, like, your XP. When you complete, like, another mode of challenges, or no, when you just complete a challenge, you get more XP. When you get all the gaps, you get 1,000 XP. And every 5,000 XP things, I think, you get another bike. And, like, it just opens up more parts of the game, basically. XP is a progress meter, basically.
Okay. So, that's not a... like, the getting over all the gaps is not a thing that's specific to this level, like knocking down 4 ladders, which I assume there aren't just ladders scattered all over the game.
Right. There are gaps in every level. and every level has a 1,000 XP bonus.
Okay, that makes sense. Because I was wondering why that showed up, even though it wasn't the novice challenge. But that makes sense. Okay.
I'm just gonna preface right now, before the video gets to like the hardcore and insane challenges, that you don't need, if you just want to see the levels, if you just want to buy the game and play through the 8 levels, and basically get to the last level and just look at it, you only need to complete the rookie and amateur challenges. Because usually the challenges that are really off-the-wall terrible to do are, I guess, hardcore and insane challenges. Now, they are sometimes way too tough for their own good, which we'll get there when we get there, but you know, the game doesn't ramp up in difficulty for people who just want to casually play the game. I guess I could say it's sort of like Jet X2O in that you don't need to play Expert Mode. Expert Mode is probably way too hard for its own good, but you don't need to play it. However, I'm going to say some positives about Dave Mirra before I launch into the negatives, because the negatives will demonstrate themselves later on. Like I said, Dave Mirra has a really nice tricking system. The square button and then a direction on the D-pad is a trick, and then the circle button and a direction on the D-pad is like a modifier. And yes, you can combine those together, like a one-footed X-up can-can. You can do a can-can, you can do a one-footer, or you can do a one-footed can-can. And you do that by basically pushing a direction, then the square button to do that trick. Then quickly push a direction and the circle button to do that modifier. And you can basically do any modifier on any trick. Now you can't do like a Superman no-footer, because Superman is already no-foot. Like, it'll just stop your trick right there, but the back of the game advertises that there are over 1,000 tricks in the game. Which there probably are.
Like, if you do the math, probably are, yeah. And one thing that I'm noticing here that I think is a positive, someone who knows extreme sports games better than I do might think of as a negative, that it's showing you your goals glowing. That wasn't in aggressive inline.
Yeah, I like that. That's nice. And even if you don't see a goal, if you kind of ride by the goal, the goal will pop up blue in the top right corner. Say you're looking for a rail to grind, but you don't know exactly where it is. Well, if you go kind of by the rail, it'll show up blue in the top right corner, and that'll be nice.
Yeah, like that.
And a fourth of your challenges, you have to find a rider and talk to them to get the challenge, which that is, I guess, sort of, it's sort of a positive and a negative, because what they do is, like, if you've completed, let's say, the pro challenges, and you need to, and you need to find the one hardcore challenge to, you know, where you need to talk to a guy, you can talk to any of the guys you've talked to before, and they'll be like, oh, go meet up with so-and-so, he's down by this building.
That's kind of nice. That's kind of nice, I think.
They don't tell you exactly where the rider will be, and so sometimes the rider is in a really weird spot.
I think it's a little odd that you have to quit the run and then start another run to do this. Do you have to? Or
to, if you finish up like another thing of challenges, like if you beat all the pro challenges. Let's say you have one pro challenge left, you start a new 3-minute run. You do the pro challenge in 30 seconds. The hardcore challenges won't just unlock. You have to end the run and start a new one.
Yeah, I think that's a little odd. Maybe I'm alone in that, but I think that's a little strange.
No, it was like, it's one of those things that I never noticed about aggressive inline, because it took some context. Like, this game not doing things that game did, where if you do a challenge in aggressive inline that unlocks other challenges, those challenges will just automatically show up for you as new and needed to be completed.
Yeah.
Basically, you know, I can't really call Dave Mirra 2 a compilation of back steps because it came out first. But, you know, like I said, in my eyes, at least, aggressive inline has definitely become a list of improvements.
Yeah.
And, I mean, sure, we're done with that game. I can't say these things over gameplay of aggressive inline. I just want to give that game its credit, since I didn't really give it at the time. Wall rides. Wall rides are one of those things that are really weird. Like, wall rides are a good example of just kind of the weird part of the game. Like,
did they fix anything about wall rides, or are they just as weird? Or weirder?
Actually, I wouldn't call the wall rides weird in aggressive inline. Sure, maybe they were... Okay, maybe they were a little easy? I see what you're saying. Yeah, aggressive inline, for some reason, you had to go, like, pretty much straight at the wall. But when you actually did a wall ride, you felt much more in control. Like, wall rides here, I don't know, you just kind of stick to the wall, and then you can't really, like, jump off of it or anything. Like, you're mashing the X button to try to jump, and your guy's just like, nope. All right. And with this challenge, grinding 525 feet, probably comes however many minutes of time I left in me trying to do this, and I'm probably going to just start bitching for the entire amount, because you have about 530 feet of rail to try to grind 525 feet of, and that wouldn't really be a problem in a game such as Tony Hawk or such, where they'd make sure that it was easy to jump from rail to rail. But I don't know if this was an oversight, or if Z-Axis really intended this to be extremely hard. Because, I mean, it is a hardcore challenge, but, like, the other hardcore challenges were wall ride in four places, you know? But, like, these rails, you really can't jump between them. So, you know, you could say, like, oh, manual between them. Manualing works about a fourth of the time.
So, this isn't... grind 525 feet of rail. It's grind 525 feet of rail in one trick combo.
Yes.
That sounds terrible.
And I've heard that you can, like, grind these rails and then keep a manual and go grind some other rails, but that hasn't really worked for me. Like, when I go find another rail after, like, 30 seconds of manualing, and I go to grind that, and the grind bar goes over 525 feet, that hasn't given me that challenge for me. But, I mean, there are, like, four issues here. And if they fixed, like, even one of them, it would be much easier. You know, if manualing worked more consistently, if I could actually jump between these, like, sometimes I can do it. This one I can, those rails I can pretty much jump between every time, but, like, there's no way I'd be able to jump between those two. And if awkward landings didn't happen so often, like, if you bump against something wrong, you're gonna fall off your bike. Like, aggressive inline, they did a pretty good job of you staying up. So this is my successful run, where I have to grind up first, then manual around and down, and sure, I'm kind of playing it safe at this point, because this is after, like, 15 minutes of recording. And admittedly, I missed a whole lot of this rail. That rail's, like, 100 feet long. But I don't know. It just feels wrong. It just feels... And I still barely got it. It just felt... Sorry. Wow. In any other game, I'd be making it harder than it is. But in Dave Mirra 2, that's pretty much the only way that you can do it. And so each level also has, like, one or maybe two challenges that are so much harder than the other challenges. With the other challenges around it. And they don't even need to be in the higher tiers. Like, you've probably picked up on it, but... Rookie challenge is the first one you get when you start a level. Like, you need to get a certain amount of points to open up any challenges. Then there's amateur. Also, these are some signature moves right here. Then there's amateur challenges. There's four of those. then there's pro challenges for those, then hardcore challenges for those, then an insane challenge. And the insane challenge is supposed to be the hardest challenge in the level, but after grinding 525 feet, this is pretty much a piece of cake. Well, getting up to the guy isn't a piece of cake. What you have to do is you have to get up to the roof, so you have to ride up the slide. And the bowl really isn't very good at showing you where the slide is. Like, again, this isn't my first time playing the level. Another thing Aggressive Inline added, the ability to, even when you're stopped, the ability to look around. Like, up and down.
Yeah.
Like, I'd be able to line myself up and get the jump, like, first try here. But, yeah, I gotta get on this slide, and it's pretty much easier to do it just from the side. In which case, then you need to make sure you stay on the slide.
Yeah, I remember you were practicing this, and it seemed kind of ridiculous. Yeah. Oh, that's Dave Mirra?
Yeah. Blank Tester doesn't need to take my word for it. I had him try to play this game for like 5 minutes. You want to make any remarks on that?
The only extreme sports game that I have played and finished, and by played and finished I mean like I bought the game, I still own the game, and that's the newest SSX, like the one that came out for the newest consoles. And this game is very different than that game.
I mean, you played a little bit of SSX Tricky just by de facto, or however you say it, of being friends with me, Alan, Beerda, who owned SSX Tricky, and then Tinker, who the internet doesn't know, but... Just by being friends with
just
a bunch
of bad, yeah.
By virtue of being friends with people who own us like the old SSXs and have played them, you know, we've passed the controller off several times. You know, we used to pass the controller off a lot up until I'd take the controller and outscore everyone 4 times. You know, I mean by 4x.
Yeah. Thanks for that clarification.
It's the curse of being so good.
Twice. They only gave me the controller twice.
Really?
And I'm not complaining because I was so piss poor at the game.
I thought you played more than twice.
I played SSX Tricky more than twice in my life, but with you guys, I've only played it twice because I'm so piss poor at the game. Not even just in comparison to you guys. I mean, I'm just generally piss poor at the game. So, you know, I can barely get a decent score in the newest one, and that one's pretty dumbed down compared to Tricky. And this game, its controls are very different, and I'm fucking terrible at it. It would be kind of amusing if you guys watched, but not so amusing that you would want to watch a whole episode about that. Like maybe a 1 minute clip.
I mean, maybe this is a bad game for you to try, because even I am fighting the game itself, basically, and I managed to string together something respectably decent, you know, finish the level in a little under 20 minutes.
With 15 minutes of footage cut out.
Yeah. I mean, I was playing this level, and... That rail challenge. Basically what happened is that, I don't know, the first time I was playing through the level, I was trying it over and over and over, and I wasn't getting it at all, because... this video, even with me messing it up like 3 or so times, I made it look so much easier than it actually is. Just because I cut out 15 minutes of me sucking. If you have the game, at least, like, this is the first level. If you have the game and you want to... remember for yourself, just play the first level. You don't need to play the second if you don't like it. I went off on a tangent. But, oh yeah, so the first time I was playing the level, I don't know, I just wasn't getting it, and Alan walked into the room, and I'm like, oh my god, I can't get this challenge. It's so It's so freaking tough, I can't... Oh, I just did it.
Yep.
We went over that. In Sedek's third law, whenever you get really annoyed that something's taking too long, it'll resolve itself immediately after. So that that recording of me doing that challenge right there is the second time I ever pulled that one off. Like, I don't know. Can I say that one is so much harder than all the other ones enough times?
Yes. I'll say yes, because I didn't quite understand your phrasing. Yes. So next one's train yards?
Yep.
All right.
I hope you like trains.
I fucking love trains.
All right, make sure to join the two of us on the next level, Train Yards. That was it for Woodward Camp. And I hope that if you haven't played Dave Mirra 2 and you're watching this, hopefully you enjoy the videos. I've gotten kind of a split between this game and Matt Hoffman 2. Like, I've gotten requests to play Matt Hoffman 2, but I've also got people going, oh yeah, I can't wait for Dave Mirra. Will I do Matt Hoffman 2? I don't know. Usually I stick to games that I played before. However, when I put this game back in the PS2, I wondered why I couldn't remember any of the later episodes. I mean, later levels. And then I played it. And then I remembered. See you guys later, when I finally beat this game.